The Mars day is 24 hours and 40 minutes. So at first, this is a very good thing. You go into work at 8 o'clock in the morning one day, then 8:40, then 9:20, and life's great. But eventually, it rotates through, and you're going into work at 2 in the morning, and 2:40, and 3:20, and that's when your shift starts. So you're out of sync with Earth, but you're in sync with Mars. Creates a lot of camaraderie amongst the science and engineering teams because you're all stuck working this absolutely crazy schedule with no one to talk to except one another. The other thing it does though is it's very difficult to do everyday things like eat, for example, because when you're off your shift, you're probably supposed to be sleeping, but that might be the only time the grocery stores and restaurants are open. So what happens is that the rover wakes up shortly after sunrise, looks to Earth for a set of commands, receives that set of commands, and then throughout the day executes it. Later in the afternoon, there's a communications pass where all the data that the rover has collected through its day of work, independently from us on Earth, its drives, its sampling, its images, all of that data is then uplinked back to JPL, where the science and engineering teams are eagerly awaiting to see what happened that day.
And then it's this like science free-for-all of like, I want to go to that rock. No, I want to go to that rock. And I want to go over there. And, you know, it's a hard problem to wrangle all these scientists and get them to have consensus on what they want to do. And then once there's consensus, then they say, okay, we're going to make progress towards here, and along the way we're going to stop at this rock and do some investigation. And then it's our job to turn kind of that into commands that we send to the rover. So we, you know, drive forward 1 meter, turn right, drive forward another meter, deploy your robotic arm, take these pictures. We kind of write out a laundry list of all the things that we want the rover to do that day. We kind of email it to the rover. It wakes up in the morning and it does the things that, you know, we told it to do. And then it emails us back in the evening and says, hey, I made it. And here's some pictures and here's your science. And then it goes to sleep. And then we kind of plan the next day.
And you work throughout the Mars night then as the rover is typically asleep to create the plan for the next day, decide what kind of scientific activities you want to do, sequence those activities. And then by the time that rover wakes up the next morning and looks to Earth, that command load has to be ready and coming. So that's why we work on Mars time.
Live on Mars time, yeah. I've got a 3-month-old and a 3-year-old at home, and I'm going to be living on Mars time. So my life is going to be a little chaotic.